The first probably a case in a long time which I had recently where after doing so many cases I had embolization of the stent and I really had lost my touch how to deal with these kind of cases, and it's good that I came for this talk. I read up a lot, so now I know how to deal with it better. So you can see that in this patient we had a very complex LAD. This was a young guy, triple vessel. I had finished the RCA, went for the LAD. There's a double bend in the LAD, and you can see that on the wire. I had some difficulty in getting the wire down, and unfortunately, despite repeated attempts with having buddy wire everywhere, first in the circ, then in the LAD, then in the diagonal, my stent would not go down past the first lesion. And in attempting to withdraw the stent back into the guiding catheter here, now I lost the stent, the balloon has come back, and you can see that the stent has dropped here. I tried to get a snare down.
The moment
I was trying to get the snare down, it would be pushing the stent a bit further. I still persisted with that idea because I thought that this is not a good position to deploy the stent because it's partially in the left main. So in trying to get aggressive with the snare, now you can see I've lost everything. My wires have come out, the stent is hanging there, and you can see unfortunately that all hell is breaking loose because the LAD is now closing because of a big dissection flap. Now here I made a cardinal mistake, which I think you all should understand, that if there is a dissection flap and you're trying to snare the stent, because you will have to pull out the entire assembly, what you should have done is had another guiding catheter coming in, secured the LAD with another wire, and then tried to do whatever you have to do. So that was my cardinal mistake. After great difficulty, because initially also I had difficulty with all hell breaking loose, patient having pain, becoming hypotensive, managed to get the wire down. And once the wire was down, since the stent had embolized a bit further, what I decided to do is to first crush the stent with the balloon. And after having crushed the stent completely, got a second stent down here and anchored this distal end of this stent with the proximal end of the second stent so that it would not embolize any further. Because it was a drug eluting stent here, I thought I will not overlap the entire stent, which some people might do, is overlap the entire stent right from here after crushing it. And at the end, I could escape with little bit of haziness there. Earlier, I had put a small stent here also. So the basic learning from this would be that A, don't panic. Two, what you should do is have all the available hardware with you in the lab. Three, if there is a big dissection and you are trying to snare the stent out, ensure that you have another guide cath and another wire, which will make your life easy. Important is prevention is always better than cure. In tortuous and calcific arteries, accept difficulty in delivering stents. This is what we forget all the time. Use large diameter guiding catheters with good coaxial support so that the stent can be withdrawn safely if required. Use support wires like the Grand Slam or buddy wires or guideliner, anticipating difficulty. Prepare the bed well. Have a low threshold to use rotablator or a flexstone balloon so that you can prepare the bed well. Now, in case of stent embolization, if the stent is on the wire, in the coronary and the balloon is still partially in the stent, the option would be to deploy at this site if it is acceptable, if it's not in the left main, or you inflate the balloon partially and try and withdraw the whole assembly including the guiding catheter, wire and the partially inflated balloon with the trapped stent through the femoral sheath. Of course, here you have to ensure that there is no dissection flap and if required, access the coronary with another guide cath and put a wire. If the stent is still on the wire but the coronary balloon has completely come out of the stent, options for this patient would be advance a small low profile balloon and deploy if the position is acceptable, or you try and advance a low profile balloon 1.5 or 2 millimeter beyond the stent, inflate at low pressure and withdraw the entire assembly including guiding catheter wire and the inflated balloon holding the stent in place through the femoral sheath. If there is a spiral dissection, secure the coronary by engaging another guiding catheter and wire, advance from this guiding catheter before withdrawing the assembly. If the femoral artery was used, you can engage the other guiding catheter from the radial or the other groin. If the balloon does not go through the stent, then try to snare the stent with a gooseneck snare. Try and use a snare of adequate size. Snare should be such the size of the coronary where the stent has embolized. Once trapped, the whole assembly is withdrawn from the femoral sheath as described earlier as a whole unit, as it is difficult to get a damaged stent back in the guiding catheter. These are some of the hardwares which should be there on the shelf of your lab: the gooseneck snare, the end snare, the Dormia basket, the retrievable forceps and a deflecting wire. We only had the gooseneck snare and we tried using that. In case if the wire has come out and the stent is now floating free in the coronary as I had, the option would be to try and snare the stent as described earlier by advancing the snare on a second wire passed by the side of the drop stent. Once trapped, the whole assembly has to be withdrawn. In case of difficulty in trapping this stent, it may have to be crushed with another stent at the site where it has lodged and another stent deployed at the lesion site. In the review of literature, Relactis et al. In their 11,000 consecutive patients found that the stent loss occurred in about 38, giving an incidence of about 0.3%. Stent loss occurred more frequently in lesions with calcification and or significant proximal angulation. In 3 patients, the stent was crushed and covered with another stent without attempting retrieval. Stent retrieval was attempted in 35 of their 38 cases and was successful in 30. The following retrieval methods were used in their series: advancing the balloon through the stent, inflating the balloon and withdrawing the stent in about half the cases, twirling 2 wires around the stent in about 5%, loop snare in about a quarter, biliary forceps in 12, Cook retained fragment retriever in about 10, and basket retrieval in about 2%. Patients in whom stent loss occurred had a higher incidence of bleeding required transfusion, about 1/4 of the patient's blood, and more often required emergency coronary artery bypass surgery, 5% versus 0.5%. No patients in whom the stent was crushed or deployed in the coronary artery had any major cardiac complication. Stent loss occurs during PCI infrequently. Lost stents can be successfully retrieved in the majority of cases using a variety of retrieval technique, yet stent loss is associated with an increased risk of complication. Stent deployment or crushing may be a good alternative to retrieval. Anand Prasad et al. Report of their case: with the advent of modern thin coronary stud stents, there is a potential damage to the stent during delivery. Fraying of the stent during unsuccessful attempts at lesion passage can be particularly problematic as re-entry into the guiding catheter may not be possible. They describe a case of unsuccessful delivery of coronary stent complicated by deformation of the proximal stent edge. rendering the stent unable to be retrieved through the guiding catheter. Intravascular removal of the stent from the balloon with subsequent use of a peripheral vascular crossover sheath, as was shown earlier, to snare the Fred stent has been described by them. So this was the vessel which they were attempting, a very long segment, tortuous LAD. The guiding catheter, stent delivery system and coronary wire were pulled back as one unit into the right common femoral artery. The guide catheter was first pulled out into the 6 French femoral sheath. The stent balloon system was then pulled back to the tip of the sheath. However, similar to the guiding catheter, the frayed stent would not pass to the tip of the 6 French femoral sheath. So this is the place where the stent is coming stuck. So they took an 8 French sheath, was placed in the left femoral artery, and an exchange length extra support termo glide wire was advanced into the right external iliac using a 5 French soft view omniflush catheter for support. The omniflush catheter and the short 8 French sheath were exchanged out for an 8 French Ansel modification peripheral sheath. In preparation for retrieval, the stent was removed from its balloon by gently pulling down against the tip of the right femoral sheath, thus stripping off the undeployed stent on the wire. Great care was taken to ensure that it remained on the wire. The balloon catheter and guide were completely removed from the patient. A 4 mm diameter, 120 cm Amplatz gooseneck snare device was introduced through the Ansel sheath and advanced into the right femoral artery. The coronary wire in the right femoral artery was advanced by a second operator to meet the snare. The coronary wire was successfully snared and the snare was walked down the wire to the stent. The stent was then snared in its midbody and externalized from the patient through the Ansel sheath in the left groin. So this is the diagram where they have got the snare from the other side through the Ansel sheath, and this is how they managed to pull it out. So maybe you could probably consider this option also if your stent does not come out through the femoral sheath. And there has been a case report of use of intravascular ultrasound to localize a dropped stent and also to see that it is adequately crushed by another stent which was deployed to crush this initial stent. So this is one case report which is there in the literature. So the take-home messages are: a variety of treatment strategies for salvage after stent dislodgement have been described, including in-situ deployment, retrieval, and crushing of the stent with another stent. And with that, I thank you for a patient hearing.
This is never retrieve, pull out your wire. If you have lost the stent, if your wire is across the stent, then you can put another, even if you don't have snares in the cath lab, put another wire across and do Chinese bleach, you know, you just run one over the other, put both in one connector and twist them. The twist catches the stent and then you can pull it out. So, most important thing in that is if you lose a wire, then it becomes very difficult.
So, adequate preparation is a very essential step in before deploying a stent. This stent embolization is usually occurs the bed is not prepared adequately. When you are trying to push a stent through a stent catheter through the inadequately prepared stent, these complications can occur. So preparing the bed is an important step before deploying a stent.
And we proceed with the snare. If you're using the gooseneck snare, I don't know what the other operators like to do, but you have the delivery catheter, and you load, just have it just a little bit outside the delivery catheter, and you load it over the wire that the stent is on. And so you advance the snare over that wire, and then when you get to the stent, where the stent is, you open the snare a little bit more, and you can sort of just wiggle it over the stent. That way you already capture the stent because you've advanced the snare over the wire that the stent was lost on. And you can do that with the delivery catheters with those gooseneck snares. And that, as soon as you get a little bit on, then you tighten it and you can pull it out.